You promise you'll listen closer?
No, I wasn't really going to.
Okay, hurry up. Did you enjoy what Russell told you?
Yes.
You believe it was truth?
Yes.
I know it's truth, it's good stuff. You know, I've never thought about the comparison of grace and truth. But isn't it amazing how God says you got to have a balance? Because you can be completely crazy with grace and never learn the truth. We need to have a balance. That's good stuff. I like that. And you know what? It's pretty obvious to me that in the midst of everything, because I don't think God's through with our church. How about you? I don't think he's through with us. The Bible says don't despise the day of small things. I don't. And I had some things I wanted to say to you this morning, but I will proceed at a date. Because you know what? How many of you know God knows how to get folks' attention? Does he know how to get, you know what? You know, I'll tell you what, let me just elaborate a little bit, because I never told nobody of my little Facebook message to Russell at her staff. I never told anybody because it was nobody else's business. That was between me and the Holy Ghost and them, period. Now, if Russell shares it, that's his business. It's not my business to share because it was something between the Holy Ghost. See, you got to understand where I was at. I was out on the machine working. And I don't know if you know this, but the Holy Ghost was out there too. He kind of follows me around. He kind of dwells in me, you know what I mean? And I'm listening to my Bible and playing my music. Well, whatever I was doing, I don't remember very much, but I remember the place I was at. I could take you probably to the tree I was threading or thrashing right in that area. And I remember all of a sudden this feeling comes on me. How many of you know what it feels like when the Holy Ghost goes, ooh? It's like I become a blubbering fool. I can't contain that. You know, I just start to weep. I can't contain him. Sorry, I just can't. And this lump comes up in my throat and I'm going, what in the world? I'm working, Holy Ghost. But the Holy Ghost just begins to show me or to say this to me. And I said to myself, go tell somebody else. I don't really want to tell these people this stuff. And it wasn't a bad thing, okay? But I thought, you know what? You know what my fear was? I'm going to tell you my fear. They're not going to receive it from me. Maybe they don't think that God speaks to me anymore. You ever thought that way? The dumb things you think. But you know, hey, I thought that way. I thought, you know what? There's bound to be a holier man out there than me that you can speak to that they'll have confidence in. And I said, I'm going to put that thing on the shelf for a while. So I did. And I knew exactly the words that he'd given me. But I shelved them for 5 days. But you know what? When 5 days goes by and you can't get away from it, you're going, there's something going on with me. I can't quit. So I remember telling Kelly, I got to send these guys a message. I have to. If I don't, I'm going to be disobedient and God's going to hold me accountable. I can't do it anymore. So I sent them a little message in their Facebook. And this is the God honest truth. I sent it and I shut it off immediately. I said, I don't want to even see what's happening. I'm just shutting Facebook off. And I left it off. And finally, I came to Kelly. I said, do you think they ever read that? She goes, oh, yeah. I don't know how she knew they read it. Does it tell you they read it? She goes, oh, yeah, they read it so-and-so at this time. I'm going, really? Oh, boy. And what thrilled me and scared me at the same time as that next Sunday morning, guess who walks through the door? It was Father's Day, wasn't it? It was the next day that maybe was Father's Day? Okay, well anyway, I couldn't quit crying. Because you know what? For me, there's nothing better than to have the Holy Ghost confirm something both ways. To me, that's powerful. I think that's powerful. And I don't know, maybe you wondered, I wonder why they showed back up. You ever thought that? Well, why? Just out of the blue, here comes Russell through the door. Whoa, here he comes. Why? Well, that was none of your business. That was between me and the Holy Ghost and them. But since he shared it, it's okay. But thank you for being obedient into what I thought was the Holy Ghost. And I still think I was right. Not that I was right, but I believe the Holy Ghost knows what he's doing. And you know what? Do you believe that possibly an outside chance that that's a start of something fresh?
Yeah.
Hey, it could be a start of something. I want to tell you, see, I got notes up here that you need to know about. So I'm going to do this for you. Look, at it's 12:14, so it's 12, probably 12:10. Because that clock is wrong. But I want you all to look me in the eye and tell me, I promise you, no, come on, you got to talk to me. It's not fair that you just sit there looking at me and you say, I promise you, I'm looking right at you, that I will come back tonight. Okay, see, I got you. Well, you promised me, buddy. You're on the hook. See, you thought I was going to give you something. Because I want you to hear this. This is important stuff. But you know what, Russell? It was God's plan that he would teach us today. That's the truth. And everything he said was right on target. Thank you. I'm not kidding. Thank you. How many of you know it is a body ministry? You might say, well, you never gave me that opportunity. Hey, anytime you would like, the opportunity is yours. You say, the Holy Ghost has been dealing with me and I never have the opportunity to tell. Well, just come up here and tell. Because you're just as important as I am. You know, when Russell was talking about football, did you know that the quarterback gets all the credit, but you know what? He's going to get scrambled if somebody don't protect that cat. It's a team effort. Everybody plays together, right? You say, boy, he's a good quarterback only because he's got a front line that don't let him get hammered. Right?
Yeah.
You got to have all of them. Am I right? Everybody's important. I know the quarterback, he gets a lot of credit, but he's no more important than that left guard or that left tackle. He's important on that offensive line. Is that right? Sure it is.
Yeah.
See, yeah.
Oh,
go ahead.
I read this book by this Christian football coach, and he coaches a high school team they're top 10 in the nation, and they're you know, this is kind of the age of the private schools, because the private schools can recruit kids. Like, the first person that I saw that came out of that was LeBron James. There's schools that call themselves a private school, and they're a Catholic. Most of them are Catholic.
Uh-huh.
And but what they are is it's big money. And I don't know if there's anything wrong with it or not, but at any rate, there's Bishop Gorman is in Vegas. They're number one in the country. Number one high school football team in the country. They're a private school. They recruit kids from all over the country, and their staff, they have a great football team. Well, anyways, this guy is a Christian fellow who played pro football. I don't have to do his name. Anyways, so he wrote these books on coaching, a couple of them, and he's a top 10 ranked school in the nation, and he's just a regular old, like Kingman High School or Lee Williams High School, just a regular old school. So this guy is a good coach. And anyways, so he really knows. You know, the thing about football is there ain't but about six plays in football. You know, there's a two back through this hole, three back through this hole, and there's about four different formations, and that's it. At the end of the day, it's you're imposing your will on the other guy. If I can move you out of the way, my running back can run by you, we're gonna win the game. You know, and attack me. But this coach, I loved reading his book, and he told the coaches, he told the kids every single day, they were all huddled up, and he said, what's my job? And the kids said, to love us. And they bought it, you know.
That's fantastic.
And he goes, what's your job? To love each other. And I thought, oh my gosh, that's the way church is, you know. Our job is to love each other, you know, and then other people try, you know. That's the only thing we got to get right. You know?
That's good stuff right there.
Right, you know? It's just loving one another.
That's awesome.
You
know? So. That's fantastic. Yeah.
Anyhow, honestly, the cashier ran at that thing, and I looked I can really feel, I'm thinking, is this the devil? Or is this God telling me I should? I can't think of any of them. Larry's been teaching us, preaching us, telling everybody, so Larry, I'm not so bad. They said, you blame it on Larry? I said, no. Because, you know, I was torn. What do I do? Everybody said, just let it go, Melvin. You did what you thought was right.
Yes, sir.
She's not paying me.
Yes, sir.
Well, it went on and on, and I ran into her town, and I pulled her off. You know, but finally I said, but I thought, you know, even though she's going around here, but people, she's an angel.
Sure she is.
I did what I thought was right.
Absolutely.
But I didn't enough to, let me tell you. Like I said, I thought, yeah, what's wrong here saying, you're not helping, I'm paying. And God said, you know, Larry said we should help people. But I got over it.
Yeah, well, go ahead, praise the Lord. Well, you know what?
He says, praise the Lord, God, you're not answering your anymore.
Hey, whether you like it or not, whether I like it or not, Jesus loves that lady. And I'm not telling you that you were wrong in helping her or right with helping her. You did what was right in your own heart. You found out she was a con. But even Jesus loves cons. And you know what? She'll answer with God. All you did was what was it? What you know, ultimately that's all we can do. I mean, I know I've helped people before and I'm thinking, that was a rat hole. Well, I know she
said,
I know. I'm going to move Russell's water because I want y'all to come down here. Russell couldn't have some proper, but I don't know if I can spill it there.